Right, let's make a kitchen knife. I'm aiming for about 100 layer Damascus this time, so we'll start with 5 bits of carbon steel, 5 bits of nickel steel, and fold that a few times. Assert dominance over your steel by making it scream when you put it in the fire. I really should dry this flux. It's clearly soaked up a lot of moisture. I've taken quite a liking to doing a lot of the forging using this little fly press. It's consistent, it's quiet, and it's a lot easier on my joints. I made a little drawing attachment that just clamps onto the bottom and makes it much faster to lengthen the steel. I really do need to bolt the table down much more firmly. Right, we had 10 layers. Now, if we stack it 3 times, we go up to 30. If I had been thinking more carefully, I would have put some extra layers in between to get 32, but alas. Time to cut it into another 3 bits, stack them, weld them, and draw it out again to get us up to 90 layers. Close enough to 100. I don't need the handle anymore, so I chop it off at an angle to help form the tip a little bit faster. Can't do these parts on the press, not yet anyway, but forging is fun, that's why I do it. Forge the tip to a point and rough out the shape of a handle. Time to make the pattern a bit more interesting. The steel is way thicker than I want for a knife so that I can cut something into it. In this case, I'm cutting some long teeth into the edge. Mark things out with a saw and then file down through most of the billet. Time for the last little bit of forging, bringing it to length and shape. This is a very useful little gizmo, a hardy flatter. Gives you a nice flat finish without needing someone else to hold the flatter for you. That might be the straightest one of my blades has ever come out of a quench. Right, time to grind things to final shape. Possibly the best upgrade I've had in ages is this little bit of wood, saving my fingernails from smacking into the belt. Hand sanding. Slow, tedious, but very important. And it sure does give nice results. Acid time. Make sure the steel is clean. Super clean. Like spotlessly clean. After about 30 minutes in the ferric chloride and a bath in the neutralizing solution, it's looking quite nice. Time for a good long soak in coffee to make it even nicer. I got some nice looking epoxy resin and wood scale things, and some blue G10 liner for the handle. Thank you. The scales are just dry-fitted onto the knife for now. Once they conform to the steel, I'll take them off and sculpt them properly. There's a bit more work to do to them, but let's get a little peek at what they're looking like now. Ooh, yeah. This is a little trick I've been hearing about. Put a little bit of Vaseline on all the parts you don't want the epoxy to stick to make the cleanup easier. It did work quite well. And there we are. I should have cut those teeth in a little bit longer, but I'm quite happy with it.